Hello students, I welcome to all of you to this session of fluid mechanics. Dear students, you know that already we have discussed lot of things related to fluid mechanics. The last in the previous chapter we have seen in chapter 9, chapter 10, laminar flow and turbulent flow also discussed, and how what is Reynolds number, what is the condition to get laminar flow, turbulent flow, that also discussed. And today in this lecture we'll be going to discuss about the flow through pipes. So flow through pipe means when the water is flowing through a pipe, where it may be fully, that means partially or fully, the pipe full of water, or it is partially full of water. Okay, so in this case, okay, basically in this chapter the pipes are partially full, as in the case of sewer line the pressure inside the pipe is same and equal to the atmospheric pressure. Okay, so what will be the condition and what will be the frictional dissipation, frictional loss, that will be discussed here. So basically we will be discussing about the energy loss, loss of energy inside the pipe when the fluid is flowing through a pipe. Okay, so that will be discussed. Before coming to the discussion, let us introduce myself. I am Dhiraj Mondol, assistant professor, JIS College of Engineering, Mechanical Engineering Department. This is my YouTube channel, DM Study Center. You can follow this link and you can follow this YouTube channel to get all the lecture related to mechanical engineering and some GS related subject like Constitution of India, History, Geography and Current Affairs. Okay, so for PDF you can join my Telegram channel, DM Study Center Official. Here you will be getting all the notes related to this PPT file, PDF file related to the subject. You can get all the notes, and also everyday newspaper is uploaded in this Telegram channel. You can join here. In case if you want to join me in Facebook, this is my link, Facebook link, and my email ID dhiraj.mondol@gis.ac.in. All the assignments should be submitted in this email ID, and this is my phone number. In case any kind of doubt, any kind of query, you can call me here or you can WhatsApp me, and the query related to admission you can also call me here. Admission is open for NGIS College of Engineering, Department of Mechanical Engineering. Admission is open for 2020. You can call here, you can contact here. This is the college website. Okay, so you know that GIS College of Engineering basically a college where the first flip learning class initiated in the country. Okay, the contact number is given, you can contact here. Okay, this is the contact number. You know that the GIS College of Engineering, it is basically according to the India Today first private engineering college in West Bengal. Okay, and all the GNIT, Dr. Sudhir Chandra, these all are under this rank, one, first, second, third, second, fifth, you can see here. Okay, so GIS College of Engineering, NIRF rank, it is NIRF ranked, AICT approval, and Department of Mechanical Engineering, it is your NBA accredited college department. So any kind of query, any kind of, this is the phone number of our HOD and this is the phone number of our registrar ma'am. Okay, you can connect here or you can call me. Okay, so without wasting time, let us consider the discuss the flow through pipes. Basically when the pipe, that means here basically when the fluid is flowing through a pipe, then what will be the condition, what will be the pressure loss, that will be discussed here. Okay, so you know that Reynolds number, what is Reynolds number? It is basically the ratio of inertia force to viscous force. What do you mean by inertia? That means ratio of inertia force by viscous force. If I want to say in the mathematical expression, it is your रो वी डी बाई म्यू और वी डी बाई न्यू, वी डी बाई न्यू, दिस इज द रेनॉल्ड्स नंबर. नाउ इट इज अ नॉन डायमेंशनल नंबर, डायमेंशनल नंबर वेयर इफ द रेनॉल्ड्स नंबर इज लेस देन 2000 देन द फ्लूइड इज कॉल्ड योर लैमिनर फ्लो. इफ द रेनॉल्ड्स नंबर इज योर greater than 2000 and less than 4000, then it will be called, it is your transition state. And if it is greater than 4000, then it will be called turbulent flow. Okay, so this is the condition. So in previous chapter already we have seen that the Reynolds number, how it is varying and what is the condition, which type of flow it is. In this chapter, the turbulent flow of fluid through pipes running full will be considered. Okay, turbulent flow of fluid through pipe running full will be considered if pipe are partially full, as in case of sewer line, the pressure inside the pipe is same and equal to atmospheric pressure. Okay. Then the flow of fluid in the pipe is not under pressure. In this case, will be taken in the chapter of the flow of water through pipe through open channel. Okay, so at the when it is your partially full of water, then what will be the condition, pressure drop and all these frictional loss. Okay, here basically we will be considering the flow of fluid through pipe under pressure only. Okay, now when the fluid is flowing from one point to another point, you will see that there is some loss of pressure due to the frictional dissipation, isn't it? So if the frictional dissipation is there, then that means one layer of the fluid is gliding over another adjacent layer. So what will happen? Some frictional loss will be there and the pressure energy will be converted into heat energy or intermolecular energy. Okay, so when a fluid is flowing through a pipe, the fluid experiences some resistance due to which some of the energy of the fluid is lost. That means you will see some energies, that means we are losing some energy. So these energy can be classified into two types. One is your major energy loss and another one is your minor energy loss. What do you mean by major energy loss? Major energy loss means maximum energy lost is basically it is due to the friction, and it is calculated. That means because of friction, what will be the energy loss? That is your major energy loss. Okay, so due to the friction, what is the formula? By the help of Darcy-Weisbach formula and by the help of Chase's formula. Okay, by the help of Darcy-Weisbach formula and by the help of Chase's formula, you can find out the major loss. 4FLV² / 2GD is your Darcy-Weisbach formula. We will be discussing afterward. So here basically this is the major energy loss. What do you mean by minor energy loss? Basically the loss of energy due to sudden expansion of the pipe. Let us consider this is the pipe. Now suddenly the pipe is expanded. Due to sudden contraction, let us consider suddenly the pipe is contracted. Okay, contraction is taking place. So sudden contraction of the pipe due to bend in pipe means like this. This is the bend. Okay, when the pipe is basically bending, at that time what will be the loss due to pipe fitting means, let us consider this is a pipe number 1 and this is another pipe number 2. Now I am just, this part will be joined here. So because of the fitting, there may be some loss due to obstruction in pipe. Means when this is your pipe and the fluid is flowing, and let us consider some obstruction like a stone or anything else which is inside the pipe, and because of that the water is flowing like this. So due to this obstruction, there may be some loss. Okay, so these are the condition these are the condition. Because of this, some minor energy, it is negligible. Sometime it will be considered a negligible loss. Okay, but if it is asking that what is the energy loss due to expansion or due to contraction or due to obstruction, then you have to consider some form this energy loss, and some formula will be taken for calculation. Okay, so we will be discussing it afterward. So let us discuss about the loss of energy or heat due to friction. See, whenever I am telling you the heat means your, that means it is one types of energy in terms of meter. Okay, that means you know that energy per unit, that means your P by rho g is the pressure head. Now rho g means your W, then per unit specific weight, you can see. Okay, so P by rho g is the pressure head. Now if I am just putting the value of the unit of P, that is pressure, and unit of rho, unit of g, you will be seeing that the it is coming meter. So that is why we can say the head, it is it is one type of energy, but per unit specific weight, or it is coming in terms of meter. Clear? Now here you can see Darcy-Weisbach formula. You see, basically the loss of energy or heat in pipe due to friction is calculated from Darcy-Weisbach formula, which is derived from the chapter 10. We will be discussing, you know that this formula, here basically this formula is needed. The derivation is not needed in for your syllabus point of view. That is why I am not going to discuss it. You just remember this is the formula 4FLV² / 2GD. Okay, so in case if you want to get the derivation, I will be discussing it afterward. Just right now you just take it in keep it in your mind that HF is equal to 4FLV² / 2GD. basically it is derived in the chapter number 10. Clear? Now HF is what? HF is the loss of heat due to friction. Okay, what is the HF? Loss of heat due to friction, because of the friction, when the fluid is flowing, there must be some frictional loss here. So because of the friction, what is the loss of heat? That is your HF. What is F? Only small f, coefficient of friction, which is function of Reynolds number. Okay, so coefficient of friction, basically it is your the some constant, and it is depend upon the Reynolds number. And if it is your viscous flow, means your laminar flow, viscous flow means laminar flow, that means if Reynolds number is less than 2000, then it is called viscous flow. So if the Reynolds number is less than 2000, then at that time the F will be is equal to 16/Re. That means the formula of F is equal to 16/Re. Okay, Re is what? Reynolds number. So if you know the Reynolds number, how you can calculate the Reynolds number? You know that Reynolds number is equal to rho vd by mu. Okay, so by the help of this formula you can find out the Reynolds number. Now observe, if the Reynolds number is, let us consider coming 1500, then it will be called viscous flow, and the formula will be needed 16/Re. So this is how you can find out the F, coefficient of friction. Now L is what? Length of the pipe. V is what? Mean velocity of pipe. D is the diameter of pipe. Clear? So here in this formula, F, L, V, rho, G, D, whatever, all these 2GD, all this, I hope it is clear. What is this terminology? I hope it is clear. Now if it is clear, then come to the next slide, that is your Chase's formula or loss of heat due to friction in pipe. So by the help of Darcy-Weisbach formula and Chase's formula, we can find out the major energy losses. So what is Chase's formula? Basically अगेन फ्रॉम चैप्टर नंबर 10.3.1 द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ लॉस ऑफ हीट ड्यू टू फ्रिक्शन इन पाइप डिराइव हेयर बेसिकली यू नीड टू नो द फॉर्मूला एच एफ इज इक्वल टू एफ डॉट बाय रो जी पी बाय ए एल वी डी स्क्वायर सो कीप इट इन योर माइंड बेसिकली दिस डेरिवेशन इज नॉट नीडेड दैट इज आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू आस्क एंड डिस्कस हियर एंड एच एफ हेयर एच एफ इज व्हाट लॉस ऑफ हेड ड्यू टू फ्रिक्शन सेम पी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रो इज योर डेंसिटी जी इज योर ग्रेविटेशनल कॉन्स्टेंट बट पी इज व्हाट पी इज द वेटेड पेरीमीटर वेटेड पेरीमीटर मीन्स इफ इट इज योर पेरीमीटर द हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ दैट मीन्स हाउ मच पेरीमीटर इज वेटेड मीन इन साइड द वाटर यू कैन से ओके सो वेटेड पेरीमीटर इज द पेरीमीटर ऑफ पाइप इज योर कैपिटल पी ए इज व्हाट एरिया ऑफ द क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ पाइप सो एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ पाइप इज व्हाट ए लेंथ इज द एल इज द लेंथ ऑफ द पाइप एंड वी इज द मीन वेलोसिटी ऑफ फ्लो ओके नाउ आई होप इट इज क्लियर व्हाट इज पी व्हाट इज ए व्हाट इज एल व्हाट इज बी वी नाउ द एरिया बाय वेटेड पेरीमीटर इट इज कॉल्ड योर हाइड्रोलिक मेन डेप्थ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ए बाय पी द रेशियो ऑफ ए बाय पी एरिया ऑफ फ्लो बाय वेटेड पेरीमीटर इज कॉल्ड हाइड्रोलिक मेन डेप्थ और हाइड्रोलिक रेडियस एंड इज डिनोटेड बाय स्मॉल एम सो अगेन एम इज इक्वल टू एरिया बाय वेटेड पेरीमीटर सो कीप इट इन योर माइंड एम इज इक्वल टू एरिया बाय weighted perimeter what is area pi by 4 d square what is perimeter pi d that is your 2 pi r na so pi d if you are simplifying this one you will be getting d by 4 that is your m small m okay now if I want to substitute this value p by a here in this case so what is this a by p is equal to m so a p by a is equal to 1 by m Now put all the values, you will be getting this formula and ultimately this formula you are getting. Now rho g by f dot, it is constant. Now this we are considering root over rho g by f dot is equal to C, capital C, where C is the constant known as Chezy's constant. Okay. What is C? Chezy's constant. Chezy's constant C and C is equal to root over rho g by f dot. Okay. Now HF by L is equal to what? I is equal to HF by L. Let us consider this is your length L and the loss of heat is this. This is your I. Again I am doing this. Let us consider this is the length. And this is the loss of heat HF so here your one position and two position so this is your I you can say this is the HF not this one so ultimately HF by L is the I where I is the loss of heat per unit length of pipe what is I is the loss of heat per unit length of pipe You will be seen what is I. Okay. So basically the I hope it is clear. I what is I? So let us consider this is your length, this is your HF and this one is your I. So I is equal to HF by L. Okay. Loss of head per unit length. Clear? Now, if I am substituting the value of rho g by f dot and hf by l, we will be getting this equation. V is equal to c into root over mi. V is equal to c into root over mi. Okay. So, V is equal to c into root over mi. What is c is the where c is equal to Chezy's constant and I is the loss of heat per unit length okay m is the hydraulic mean depth okay so in the equation In equation 11.4, here this equation is known as Chase's formula. So thus, the loss of heat due to friction in pipe from the Chase's formula can be obtained if the velocity of flow through pipe and also the value of C is known. The value of M for pipe is always equal to D by 4. Okay, so the what is the value of M for pipe? D by 4. Because already I have determined here area by weighted perimeter, it is equal to D by 4. Clear? So these are the two formula by the help of which you can find out the how much energy or heat is lost. Okay, so let us take one numerical, and by the help of that we can easily understood, it can be easily understood that how the we can find out the particular loss of heat. Okay, so first problem number 11.1. First of all, go through the problem, pause the video and then try to solve it yourself, so that if you want to able to solve this problem, then it is okay, and if you could not understand, then play the video and see the last part. Okay, rest of the part. So here basically find the heat lost due to friction in a pipe of diameter 300 mm and length 50 meter through which water is flowing at a velocity of 3 meter per second using Darcy formula, Chase's formula for which C is equal to 60. So remember, C is given 60. Take nu of water, that is your kinematic viscosity, 0.01 stroke. What is stroke? Centimeter square per second. CGS unit of the kinematic viscosity is your stroke. So I hope you have solved this problem. See the problem solution. So what is the given data? Diameter of the pipe is given 0.3 meter. Length of the pipe is given 50 meter. Velocity of flow 3 meter per second. Chase is constant 60. Nu is equal to 0.01 stroke, or it can be written as 0.01 centimeter square per second. If you want to convert it in terms of newton per meter, a meter square per second, that is your SI unit, then you have to multiply with respect to with your 10 to the power minus 4, na? Okay. So Darcy formula, you know the Darcy formula, HF is equal to 4FL V square by 2GD. So 4FL V square by 2GD. So the F, whether F is given, F is not given. So let us first of all, let us find out the Reynolds number. Reynolds number is equal to VD by nu. V is given 3 meter per second. D is given 0.3 meter, and nu is given 0.01 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter square per second. So after putting the value, you will be getting Reynolds number is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 5. Okay, so what is Reynolds number? 9 into 10 to the power 5. So as it is coming 9 into 10 to the power 5, so in case of that, we can see here in this in the previous slide what we have seen. In case of that, if the Reynolds number is greater than 4000, okay, greater than 4000, that means 4000 to 10 to the power 6, then the Reynolds number is what? 0.079 by Reynolds number to the power 1 by 4. So this formula is basically fitted, or so this formula it can be adjusted in this equation, because it is your greater than 4000, that means your it is not viscous flow, it is turbulent flow. Okay, so 0.079 by Reynolds number to the power 1 by 4, that is the, you can see here. So by the help of this formula, you can put, you can find out the F is equal to 0.00256. Okay, Now what is the heat loss? HF. HF is equal to 4 F L V square by 2 G D. Put all the value rho you know, 4 F you know, L you know 50. V square means your 3 square. 2 G D. What is G? 9.81. D is the 0.3. So 0.7828 meter is the correct answer. That is the heat lost due to friction. This is called your major head loss. Okay, now in case if you want to find out the head loss by the help of the Chezy's formula, by the help of Chezy's formula, you know that Chezy's formula, V is equal to C into root over MI, where C is the Chezy's constant, M is the hydraulic mean depth, and area by weighted perimeter, and for pipe it is your D by 4, that we know. I is equal to HF by L. So here C is equal to given, M is equal to, you can find out 0.075. So put all the value in the equation. V is equal to C into root over MI. So only the I, which is unknown here, and rest of the your parameter, it is given. So here basically I is equal to what? HF by L. So L is given 50. So you can easily find out HF. HF is equal to 15 to 0.033. So that is your 1.665 meter is the correct answer, HF. Clear? So I hope it is clear. Next problem number 11.2. Let us solve another same type of problem. Okay, so try to solve it yourself. Then after that, you can see the solution. Okay, so first of all, go through the problem. Find the diameter of a pipe of length 2000 meter when the rate of flow of water through the pipe is 200 liter per second and the head lost due to friction is 4 meter. Take the value of C is equal to 50 in Chezy's formula. Okay. So you have to calculate the head lost due to friction. So first of all, try to solve it yourself. Then we will be discussing the solution. Okay. So here you can see, given data is your length of the pipe 2000 meter, discharge 200 liter per second. If you want to convert it, the liter per second, if you want to convert it, simply you have to divide by 1000. So 0.2 meter cube per second, that is your SI unit of the discharge right now. Okay, so it is your liter per second to meter cube per second, you have to convert it. Okay. Now, heat lost due to friction, HF is equal to what? 4 meter. It is given. C is equal to 50. C is equal to 50 means Chezy's constant. Okay. Already you know that what is Chezy's constant. Here you can see this Chezy's constant rho g by f dot. Okay. So, here you can see. So, next is your, let the diameter of the pipe is equal to D. So V is equal to, you know that Q is equal to area into velocity. So V is equal to discharge by area. So put all the value of discharge and the diameter. Okay. Basically, put the value of discharge. So here basically, this is the V. 0.2 into 4 by pi D square. So that pi D square I don't know. So here what I have get, V is equal to 0.8 by pi D square. Now the hydraulic mean depth, M is equal to what? For pipe it is equal to D by 4. So this is the D by 4. Now I is equal to, what is I? Loss of head per unit length. So it is your HF by L. So HF by L, HF is equal to 4, it is given here in this equation, in this question, and L is equal to 2000. So ultimately I is equal to 0.002. Okay. So the Chezy's formula is given as, given by the equation V is equal to C into MI, root over MI, this we know. Now put all the value. V is equal to what we have got? 0.2 into 4 by pi d square. And C is equal to, it is given 50. M is equal to what? M is equal to d by 4. And this is what? I is equal to HF by L. So put all the value, you will be getting the unknown is your D. Okay, so this is your the equation and this is the question. You have to find out the diameter of the pipe. You can see the question. Loss of head is given for 4 meter, isn't it? So ultimately the equation is coming like this, and D is equal to this figure. You can see ultimately what you have got, 553 millimeter or 0.553 meter. So this is the diameter of the pipe. Okay, so this is how you can solve a numerical, particular numerical, again another numerical, let us solve. Okay, after that it will be 11.4 will be given as homework. Okay, so all this what I have discussed, that is your assignment. You have to solve it in your home, you have to practice it in your home, and just send me to my official mail ID. Okay, 11.3, let us see the next problem. A crude oil of kinematic viscosity 0.4 stroke, 0.4 stroke, that means it is your centimeter square per second. So you have to convert it in terms of meter square per second. So the kinematic viscosity 0.4 stroke is flowing through a pipe of diameter 300 mm at the rate of 300 liter per second. Okay, so diameter is your 0.3 meter, and the discharge is given 300 liter per second, that is your 0.3 meter cube per second. Okay, find the head loss due to friction for a length of 50 meter. Okay, what is the length? 50 meter of the pipe. You have to find out the head loss due to friction. Okay, and the length is given 50 meter. Okay, now you have to find out the head loss due to friction. So all these value, nu is given, d given, discharge given, L given, V is equal to Q by area. So that is your 4.24 meter per second. Reynolds number is equal to Vd by nu. Okay, that is equal to 3.18 into 10 to the power 4. So you can see this is your greater than 4000. That means we can say it is your turbulent flow. So in case of turbulent flow, or if it is lies between 4000 to 10 to the power 5, that is your 1 lakh. If the Reynolds number lies between 4000 to 1 lakh, then the formula, you know that F is equal to 0.079 by Reynolds number to the power 1 by 4. This formula you need to know, and already I have discussed earlier. So ultimately what is the F? 0.00591 is the value of F. Now put all the value in the Darcy-Weisbach formula, and it is equal to what? HF is equal to 4FLV² / 2GD. So 4FLV² / 2GD, all the values you know. So these are the value. Okay, so this is the head loss due to friction, 3.61 meter. Very very important, very very easy numerical, and it can be asked in your exam. 11.4 is the homework. You can solve it in your home. Next class we will be discussing about the minor energy loss. So this is the end of the video. I hope it is clear. The related numerical I have discussed, Chase's formula also discussed, what is minor loss, what is major loss discussed, what is Darcy-Weisbach formula. Okay, all this discussed. So I hope it is clear. Now in case if you want to join JS College of Engineering Mechanical Engineering Department, always welcome. This is the contact number, you can connect here. Okay, NBA in Mechanical Department of Mechanical Engineering is NBA Tier 1 accredited department. Okay, for 2019-20, 2020-21 and 2021-22. Okay, so for, and this is the private engineering, first private engineering college in West Bengal, rank 1 by India Today, and it is also NIRF ranked college. So admission is open. Most welcome to JS College of Engineering. In case any doubt, any query, you can ask me here. This is my contact number. This is my email ID. All the assignment you have to submit it to my email ID. Okay. In case if you want to visit JS College of Engineering, most welcome. You can connect me or you can connect to the HOD's number. Okay. So this is the end of the video. Thank you for listening.